Welcome to Math Adventures. Today, we will be talking about fractions. In this video, we will talk about what is a common fraction, types of common fractions, and equivalent fractions. Let's start our adventure. Pizza. Let's slice it. We will slice it into equal pieces. 1, 2, 3, 4. We have 4 equal size slices. 3 slices with pepperoni and 1 slice with mushrooms. We can say that 1 slice out of total of 4 is with mushrooms. In math, we would write it as 1 over 4 or 1 quarter. Thus, a fraction represents one or several equal parts of a whole. Here we have another pizza, also with 4 pieces. Is this still the same fraction? The answer is no. The slices are not equal. Therefore, we cannot say that the mushroom slice is 1/4 of the entire pizza. How many pepperoni slices do we have now? We have 1 pepperoni slice out of a total of 2 equal sized slices. So, if expressed as a fraction, this is 1 over 2, called half. How many pepperoni slices do we have now? We have 3 pepperoni slices out of a total of 4 equal sized slices. Expressed as a fraction, we write it as 3 out of a total of 4 equal sized slices, or 3/4. What if all the pieces are pepperoni? Well, all pieces together represent a whole. We have 4 pepperoni slices, so 4 out of 4 slices represent one whole pizza. When we are talking about fraction, a whole is equal to 1. There are 3 parts in a fraction. The top number is called the numerator. It tells us the number of parts we take out of the total. In this example, we have 1 slice of pizza with mushrooms. So, we write 1. The horizontal bar is called a fraction bar. It separates the top number from the bottom number and tells us that this is a fraction. Finally, the bottom number is called the denominator. The denominator tells us the total number of equal parts in a whole. A fraction written in this way is called a common fraction. Let's practice and write the shaded part of each diagram as a proper fraction. Here we have 2 pieces shaded out of a total of 3 equal pieces. So we will write 2 above a fraction bar, the numerator, and we will write 3 at the bottom, the denominator, as we have a total of 3 squares. Next, we will have 5 squares shaded out of a total of 9 squares, so we will write it as 5 out of 9. And here, we have 2 rectangles shaded out of 5, so we will write 2 as the numerator and 5 as the denominator. Finally, we have 1/2 of a circle shaded, so we will write 1 as the numerator and 2 as the denominator. Now, let's talk about types of common fractions. We have 3 types of common fractions: proper fractions, improper fractions, and mixed fractions. In the proper fraction, the numerator, top number, is smaller than the denominator, bottom number. You can think of it as a Christmas tree, a little bit of branches on the top and a lot on the bottom. In this example, 5 is smaller than 8. So, 5/8 is a proper fraction. 5/8 also means that we are talking about 5 parts out of 8 equal parts in total. In the improper fraction, the numerator is greater than or equal to the denominator. Let's talk about first case when the numerator is greater than the denominator. You can think of it as an upside down Christmas tree. A lot of branches on top and a little bit on the bottom. In this example, 7 is greater than 4, so 7/4 is an improper fraction. What it means is that we are talking about more than one whole. In this example, the denominator, bottom number, is 4, so one whole is made out of 4 parts. However, as the numerator, top number, is 7, we have to look at one whole and 3 more parts coming from the second whole. In the second case, the top number is the same as the bottom number. When the numerator is equal to the denominator, it is called a whole fraction. A mixed fraction is formed by a whole number and a proper fraction. In this example, the denominator, bottom number, is 4, so one whole is made out of 4 parts. And then we have 3 more parts, so we need 3 parts from the second whole. Did you notice how we can represent improper fraction as a mixed fraction? 7/4 means that we have one whole made out of 4 parts, and 3 parts from the second whole. But 4 parts out of 4 parts is 1. So we can write it as 1 and 3/4. Let's practice recognizing fractions. In the first fraction, the numerator is greater than the denominator, so this is an improper fraction. In the second fraction, we have a whole number and a proper fraction, so this is a mixed fraction. The third fraction has the numerator smaller than the denominator, so this is a proper fraction. The last fraction has the numerator and the denominator equal, so this is an improper fraction. Now, let's talk about equivalent fractions. What are equivalent fractions? Well, equivalent fractions are fractions that have different numerators and denominators, but are equal to the same value. For example, 1/2 is half, and 2/4 is half, 3/6 is half, and 4/8 is half as well. Let's see how it is possible. Each box in here is of the same size, but it is divided into different number of pieces. The first box is divided into 2 equal pieces, and one piece is shaded, so the shaded portion represents 1/2 of the whole. The second box has 4 equal pieces, but 2 pieces are shaded, so the shaded portion represents 2/4, but it is still half of a box. The third box has 6 equal pieces, but 3 pieces are shaded, so the shaded portion represents 3/6. And again, it is still half of a box. Finally, the last box has 8 equal pieces, but 4 pieces are shaded, so the shaded portion represents 4/8, and again, it is still half of a box. As we just saw, all fractions here have different numerators and denominators, but are equal to the same value. And also, did you notice that the greater the denominator, the smaller the pieces are, and the more pieces are in a whole? Let's practice. In the first set of circles, we have 2 circles shaded out of a total of 8 circles. If we look closer, we will also notice that we have 4 columns of 2 circles, and the first column has all the circles shaded. So we can also write this fraction as 1 shaded column out of 4 total columns, or 1/4. What about the second set of circles? We have 6 circles shaded out of a total of 9 circles. If we look closer, we will also notice that we have 3 rows of 3 circles, and the first and second row has all the circles shaded, so we can also write this fraction as 2 shaded rows out of 3 total rows, or 2/3. Wait, if we have fractions that have different numerators and denominators, but are equal to the same value, Would it be easier to write, for example, 1/2 rather than 2/4? Yes. This is what should be done, and this is called fraction simplification or reduction. You can do it by dividing both the numerator and the denominator by the same number. We will talk more about that in our next video about fractions. Let's repeat what we had talked about today. A fraction represents one or several equal parts of a whole. There are three parts in each fraction. A numerator. This is the top number. It tells us the number of parts being considered. A fraction part. This is the horizontal part. It separates top number from the bottom number and tells us that this is a fraction. A denominator. This is the bottom number. It tells us the total number of equal parts in a whole. A fraction written in this way is called a common fraction. There are three types of fractions. Proper fraction. This is when we have numerator that is smaller than the denominator. Improper fraction. This is when we have numerator that is greater than or equal to the denominator. Mixed fraction. This is when we have a whole number and a proper fraction. Equivalent fractions are fractions that have different numerators and denominators but are equal to the same value. For example, 6/8 has the same value as 15/20. Both fractions have a value of 3/4. That's all for today. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and see you soon in the next math adventure.